Hello everyone. Welcome to Microsoft Lync Online Hybrid Deployment Presentation. My name is Salish. This presentation would cover an overview of Lync Hybrid Deployments. This deployment model will help the customer to utilize Office 365 cloud services with an on-premise gear. Most of the partners and solution integrators are familiar with on-premise deployments. This is a great opportunity for them to understand more about Office 365 hybrid services while remaining connected to the technology and concept they are already familiar with. Let's have a look at the agenda. First topic is introduction and overview, where we discuss about Lync Online hybrid product offering, objective of hybrid deployment, which are the supported deployment models and interoperability with other technologies. Second topic is Lync hybrid architecture, in which we will discuss about various scenarios associated with Lync hybrid model. We'll also look at the key element required on-premise and online for setting up a hybrid deployment. Third topic is migration and deployment, in which we will discuss about prerequisites required for setting up a hybrid deployment, various steps involved in moving a user from on-premise to online, and hybrid deployment workflow in detail. Fourth topic is feature parity and profiles, where we will compare the feature set of on-premise and online users in a hybrid deployment. It would be helpful for understanding user experience for a specific group. Finally, we'll go through a short demo on split domain configuration, user migration, and vanity domain configuration. Let's start with the first slide. Why do we choose Lync hybrid deployment model? Earlier, we had two different kinds of deployment options: either host all users in on-premise server or enable them on Office 365 Lync Online. However, most of the customers were looking at something in middle, like a transitional step where they could enable services for some user or some features on-premise and yet to have some services and users in Office 365. Lync hybrid deployment was Microsoft's answer to this requirement. Lync hybrid split domain will support same domains such as condoso.com can be used in Office 365 and on-premise Lync server. Customers now have an option to deploy hardware on-premise that can be aware of and connected to Office 365 for both services and administration. In addition, users can be moved between on-premise and online infrastructure. This rehoming of users allows an administrator a level of control about which service they use. In this way, administrators now have an ability to get the best both worlds, cloud, the services when they desire, and on-premise when they need it. Let's have a look at the deployment model in detail. Microsoft Lync Server 2013 can be deployed in three different models. One, pure on-premise server. Second, Office 365 Lync Online or partner-hosted multi-tenant solution. Third, hybrid deployment between on-premise and Office 365 Lync Online. Depends upon customer requirements. You can choose one of the deployment model. For on-premise server deployment, customers should maintain hardware, software, network infrastructure, DNS, certificates, and so on. Management and administration of the Lync server is taken care by organization itself. Office 365 Lync Online is one of the cloud offerings from Microsoft. Organizations that subscribe to Lync Online retain control over the collaboration services they offer to users, but they don't have the operational burden of on-premise server software. Office 365 servers are hosted in Microsoft data centers and are accessible to user on a wide range of devices from inside corporate network or over internet. Hybrid deployment would help the customer to extend the deployment between on-premise and cloud by using split domain topology. Some users can be hosted on-premise and some users can be hosted online. We'll discuss about Lync hybrid split domain on next slide. In split domain Lync server topology, same domain name is shared between on-premise and online. We haven't had this option before. In previous versions, we were using different SIP domain between on-premise and online in order to have a federated connectivity. Now it has been changed. For remote access, on-premise edge server will act as a proxy between on-premise and online. Hybrid deployment can be easily integrated with Microsoft applications like Exchange and SharePoint. Users, departments, organization unit can be easily moved to cloud. The remaining user can still be part of on-premise deployment. Split workload between on-premise and online is not supported. By the way, what is a workload? You can consider instant messaging, conferencing, audio-video call as a workload. Let's take an example. You have successfully deployed a Lync hybrid setup. One user has been moved from on-premise to cloud. That user must use all the workload from cloud itself. He should not split the workload between on-premise and online. If user is hosted on-premise, he should use all the workloads from on-premise server. If user is hosted online, he should use all the workloads from online servers. We will have a look at hybrid interoperability with other technologies in next slide. Lync Online can easily be integrated with Exchange and SharePoint. Both on-premise and online versions are supported. Here is the possible integration scenarios. Lync Online integration with Exchange Online. In this scenario, customer will get maximum benefits as both services are hosted in Office 365 Cloud. Let's have a look at the major features. Lync presence will be shared with Outlook. You can schedule Lync meeting using Outlook meeting add-in. Unified contact store is another highlight in which users' Lync contact will be migrated to Exchange Mailbox. Lync instant messages can be archived in Exchange Mailboxes. High-definition photograph management can be done using Outlook 2003 client. You can upload a new HD photograph from Outlook itself. Lync voicemails can be stored in Exchange Online Unified Server roles. Let's have a look at the next scenario. In this scenario, Exchange server is hosted on-premise with Lync Online. You will not get all the integration features in this scenario. However, presence and meeting scheduling are still available. If you look at SharePoint on-premise and SharePoint online, presence integration is available. Users should be able to see the presence status when they log into SharePoint sites. We'll look at Lync hybrid architecture on following slides. During hybrid deployment, customer need to consider integration options with Exchange and SharePoint. Customer may decide to migrate one application to Office 365 and other application will remain on-premise. Let's say customer want to migrate Exchange mailboxes to Office 365 and Lync will remain on-premise. In this scenario, customer can host Lync voicemails on cloud. They need to create a hosted voicemail policy to route voicemail to Exchange online UM servers. It is highly flexible to move bunch of users or remote branch office or a department to cloud. Administration and management can be done using same set of tools. Another way of migration will be based on user's profile. Light users can be migrated initially. For example, help desk tier 1 user can be moved to cloud initially. Managers and senior executives can be moved on later stage. On Lync hybrid topology, administrator can move users from on-premise to online as and when required. If user need basic features like instant messaging, VoIP-based audio, he can be placed in online. When they need more features like enterprise voice, he can be moved back to on-premise. Let's have a look at Lync online hybrid features on next slide. How does Lync hybrid deployment benefit the customer? It is critical to understand Lync hybrid features compared to previous versions. Lync Server 2010 did not have split domain architecture. Customers were forced to choose another domain name for Lync Online for setting up federation with on-premise instance. Hybrid split domain is introduced in Lync Online 2013. Shared SIP domain is a great advantage to customers, and most of the customers want to have same SIP domain for on-premise and online users. Also, they can make use of existing infrastructure like DNS, Active Directory for hybrid deployment. End user will not feel any difference when they're communicating with on-premise and online users. Lync online user will get most of the features on cloud except enterprise voice. Administrator can decide which feature they want to enable for end users. End user will not lose Lync contact when they migrate from on-premise to cloud. On-premise Lync server will export the contact to cloud during migration. Reoccurring meeting invite, which needs to be rescheduled once user is migrated from on-premise to online. Another benefit on client is redistribution of client is not required. Both on-premise and online client can be connected to each other. We will discuss about hybrid migration on next slide. For better integration and get maximum benefit, it is recommended to have user's mailbox and Lync account hosted in on-premise or in cloud. But it's certainly possible to host voicemail on cloud for an on-premise user. Interoperability point of view, N-2 versions are supported with Lync 2013, which means Lync 2010 and OCS R2 users can be migrated to Lync 2013 directly. Dry coexistence is not supported, meaning customer cannot have OCS R2, Lync 2010 and Lync 2013 server on-premise for a hybrid setup. OCS R1 and LCS versions are not at all supported. For setting up hybrid deployment with Lync online users, they must require at least one Lync 2013 server on-premise. User migration experience is based on the workload. For example, one of the users had a reoccurring Lync meeting shared with their partner. After the migration to cloud, he will have to reschedule the existing meeting. Both Lync on-premise and Lync online support same client versions. Hence, no changes are required on the client even after migration. DNS SRV record can be pointed to on-premise server for client discovery. Once user is migrated to cloud, Lync on-premise server will redirect the client registration to cloud for registration and discovery. Split workload between on-premise and online is not supported. Means user cannot have instant messaging on-premise and conferencing online. Either both workloads should be hosted on-premise or in cloud. We will discuss about hybrid architecture and components in next slide. This is a high-level architecture of Lync hybrid setup. Customer will have to deploy at least one Lync Server 2013 on-premise for setting up hybrid deployment. Lync Server 2013 can coexist with OCSR2 and Lync Server 2010. Tri-coexistence is not supported, meaning you can either have OCSR2 or Lync Server 2010 for hybrid setup. Apart from Lync Server, customer require directory sync tool and ADFS server role on-premise for setting up hybrid deployment. Directory sync tool will sync on-premise AD to cloud directory. While setting up directory sync, the tool will prompt for destination directory information and cloud admin credential to sync information from on-premise to cloud. For single sign-on, you require ADFS server role. ADFS server role will create a secured channel between on-premise AD and cloud directory. For securing communication between on-premise Federation server and Office 365 directory, you require an SSL certificate on ADFS server. Lync Edge server will act as a proxy between on-premise and cloud. All the signaling traffic will proxy to on-premise Edge server. Let's take an example. One on-premise user wanted to communicate with online user. On-premise user will notify front end server, part of on-premise pool. It will verify and confirm this user has been migrated to cloud. It will forward the connection to on-premise Edge server. Edge server will route the traffic to online cloud. Online cloud will notify a respective user regarding this request, and connection will get established between on-premise user and cloud user. So all this SIP signaling traffic will proxy via on-premise Edge server. We'll discuss about hybrid deployment and migration in coming slides. Let's have a look at the major prerequisites for Lync hybrid deployment. First of all, customer require a new Office 365 tenant. For hybrid setup, customer must provision the new version of Office 365. Existing customer should migrate to newer version before hybrid setup. ADFS 2.0 is required for single sign-on. The recommended ADFS topology for majority of Microsoft Cloud Services customer is to use the Federation server farm and proxies. We recommend to use at least two Federation servers in load balancing configuration for high availability. Federation server proxies are used to redirect client authentication request coming from outside your corporate network to Federation server farm. Deploying Federation server proxies to your existing ADFS infrastructure is necessary to enable following user scenarios, like user connecting from outside your organization network, smartphones, public computers, etc. ADFS require an SSL certificate when configuring Federation server settings. At least one Lync 2013 server should be up and running in on-premise in order to set up a hybrid deployment. It can coexist with OCSR2 and Lync 2013 server. Directory synchronization should sync on-premise AD to cloud. Depending upon business needs, directory synchronization is the most common provisioning choice for most enterprise customers who are moving to Office 365. Directory sync allows identity to be mastered on-premise, and all updates to that identity are synchronized to Office 365. There are a couple of things keep in mind when you plan implementation of directory sync. Directory preparation covers quite a few areas. They include attributes update, auditing, and planning of domain controller placement, etc. Planning requirement and functionality includes determining the permission that required to migrate users from on-premise to cloud. Let's have a look at the setup flow in detail. Let's have a look at Lync hybrid setup flow in detail. First of all, customer needs to create a new Office 365 tenant for hybrid setup. Once it is completed, customer should add the respective domain into Office 365 for verification. It will verify the ownership of the domain through TTL record and you will get the confirmation. Once it is done, customer should run Office 365 deployment readiness tool. This tool will verify network infrastructure, firewall ports, DNS record before migration. Once it is completed, customer should run directory synchronization between on-premise and cloud. It will sync AD attributes from on-premise to cloud. Once AD sync is completed, customer should create ADFS server role on-premise and request for an SSL certificate. SSL certificate is required for creating a secure channel between on-premise and cloud. Once ADFS is provisioned, they should move a couple of pilot users from on-premise to cloud and ensure that it is working. Verify user setting after migration and ensure that users, contact information, and voice route, everything is get migrated to Office 365. Once it is completed, they can schedule mass migration from on-premise to cloud. We'll look at a specific migration scenario on coming slide. Let's take an example. I want to migrate a user from on-premise to cloud. Alice is part of on-premise link pool as of now. I want to migrate the user to cloud. First of all, I'll create an Office 365 tenant. Ensure that my domain is added and verified, part of Office 365 tenant. Once it is completed, I'll initiate directory sync between on-premise AD and cloud directory. It will sync all the attributes from on-premise to cloud. Once completed, I'll associate user license for individual user. After that, I'll initiate move CS user commandlet from PowerShell and select the user. The target domain should be Office 365 link pool. Provide cloud admin credential for moving the user from on-premise to cloud. Once it is completed, the user information will be moved from on-premise to cloud. You should be able to find out user information and contact will be part of Office 365 as of now. We will look at data migration in a hybrid setup on next slide. Let's have a look at data migration scenarios from on-premise to online. During migration, users' contact information will be moved from on-premise to online. User should be able to see existing contact information even after migration. Let's have a look at reoccurring meeting invite. That should be rescheduled after migration. Take an example. One user had a meeting invite prior to the migration. Later, his account has been migrated to Office 365. He should reschedule the existing meeting invite once account has been migrated to Office 365. Lync on-premise can store voicemails on cloud. The unified messaging role in Office 365 can integrate with Lync on-premise. Unified contact store is another highlight. Once user account has been migrated from on-premise to online, user's Lync contact will be moved to Exchange mailbox. We look at coexistence scenarios in next slide. Let's have a look at hybrid coexistence with previous versions. The first scenario is customer has a Lync 2010 organization and they wanted to enable hybrid setup. Lync 2010 doesn't have split domain architecture. They should deploy at least one Lync 2013 server on-premise for setting up hybrid deployment. Lync 2010 can coexist with Lync 2013 and it will act as a proxy between Lync online and Lync on-premise. What about OCS R2 existing organization? N-2 versions are supported, so OCSR2 can coexist with Lync 2013. So they should deploy one Lync 2013 server into OCSR2 organization. Once it is completed, they should be able to set up hybrid deployment between on-premise and online. A pure Lync 2013 organization can easily set up a hybrid deployment because 2013 is already been supported. We will look at edge server configuration in next slide. Let's have a look at edge server configuration in detail. Edge server will act as a proxy between on-premise and online. All the SIP signaling traffic will flow between on-premise and online via edge server. First of all, you need to enable remote access and federation on edge server. You can run CS access edge configuration commandlet from PowerShell to enable these features. Once it is completed, you should add Office 365 domain as a new hosting provider for on-premise. New CS hosting provider commandlet should help the administrator to enable this feature. Once it is completed, you can test the user movement from on-premise to online. If settings are correct, administrator should be able to move a user from on-premise to online successfully. We look at hybrid features and profiles on next slide. Let's have a look at feature parity and profiles. First, we look at instant messaging and presence feature. Lync server on-premise will provide all the features. Rich presence. You should be able to see the presence status of a user in Office application, Outlook, SharePoint, and so on. You can make peer-to-peer VoIP call from Lync client. This feature is available in both on-premise and online. Click to communicate. It has integration with Outlook and SharePoint. You could see a contact card from Outlook itself. And more than contact card, you can make an instant messaging conversation and VoIP call from the contact card itself. Connectivity from mobile platform. Lync has wide range of mobility clients. You can connect from Nokia, Windows Phone, Android devices, iPhone, and so on. Lync has Mac supportability for on-premise and online user. There is a separate client available for Mac, and it should be able to connect from on-premise and online users. Skype interoperability is another highlight. You can add a Skype user into your Lync contact list. You should be able to see users' contact information and presence status directly from Lync itself. XMPP gateway. This specific feature is only available for on-premise user. Lync online user won't be able to communicate with Gmail and Jabber user, which are federated through XMPP gateway. Persistent chat. Again, this feature is only available for on-premise user. You won't be able to add an online user into existing chat room. We will look at voice profile in next slide. Let's have a look at Lync online meeting profile. Multi-party VoIP communication is supported on both on-premise and online. You can schedule a Lync ad hoc meeting using Outlook add-in. Desktop sharing, app sharing, and PowerPoint sharing is supported in both on-premise and online. There are various clients available like Lync web app, browser-based client, Lync client for Mac, etc. can be used for connecting to Lync platform. Mobile clients are available for meeting, and you can download client based on the mobile platform. And PSTN dial-in conferencing is specifically available for on-premise user. And online user should use a third-party ACP provider for dial-in conferencing. On-premise server would support a special deployment of 1,000 user part of the same conference, but Lync online support up to 250 users. We will look at the voice profile on next slide. Let's have a look at Lync voice profile. An on-premise user would get all the PSTN functionality. and he can make PSTN call, and he can receive calls from PSTN network, call delegation, connectivity to PBX and third-party devices, direct SIP trunk interoperability with existing PBX, call parking, call center integration and response group. These are the major features available on-premise user. And we can implement network resiliency for PSTN connectivity. Call admission control. You can control the bandwidth which is being used for PSTN connectivity. However, enterprise voice is only possible for user homed on-premise. In split domain scenario, currently online user would not get enterprise voice features. He should be homed on-premise in order to get enterprise voice. We'll have a short demo on end of the session. We will go through how to configure vulnerability domain and how to migrate a user from on-premise to online and edge server configuration. Let's have a look at Lync hybrid configuration demo. We'll go through Office 365 vulnerability domain setup. First of all, log into Office 365 admin portal. On the left-hand side, you should be able to see multiple options. Select domains under management. This option will list out all the domains available inside your tenant. Let me take an example. I want to add condesor.com as a hybrid setup domain. I have an on-premise Lync server. Active Directory domain name is condesor.com. I want to extend condesor.com to cloud. You should select condesor.com as a vanity domain inside your Office 365 tenant. There is an option available in this page called Add a Domain. You should add condesor.com as a vanity domain. Let's have a look at the option. Click on Add a Domain and select Start Step 1. It will prompt you which domain you want to add. Enter condesor.com and next it will ask you to verify condesor.com. You should ensure that the ownership of condesor.com is verified. Before clicking Done and Verify Now, you should ensure that a TTL record is published in the public DNS for condesor.com. It will take 3 to 4 hours to replicate the changes from public DNS to Lync online. Once it is completed, click on Done and Verify Now. It will change the status of vanity domain to active. Once it is completed, come back to the domain page. You should be able to see the status of condesor.com. It should be active. Once it is active, you can start configuring an edge server for hybrid setup. We will look at edge server configuration and user movement in next demo. I have an hybrid setup up and running in my lab. This specific setup is connected to Office 365. I wanted to move one user from on-premise to cloud. First of all, I'll open my Lync PowerShell or management shell, export a session using Lync admin credential. Once it is done, you should run move cs user commandlet. When you're running move cs user commandlet, you have to provide an identity which user you want to move from on-premise to cloud. Select the username and target domain is sipfed.online.link.com, which is nothing but your Office 365 cloud domain. You also need to provide hosted migration override URL. This URL can be retrieved from Office 365 site. You should also need to provide credential required for moving this user from on-premise to cloud. When you click Enter, it will ask for confirmation. Once it is done, it will move the user from on-premise to cloud. So this demo will confirm which command you need to run from on-premise to cloud in order to move a user from on-premise to cloud. You can contact partner services through partner portal email, and support communities. This information would be helpful for reference. Thank you so much for attending this session. Have a nice day.